Hi, hello, and welcome back to one of the most must-see YouTube channel for all medical students across the globe, Med Vids Made Simple. So before watching this video, please subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon nearby to get notified as soon as I upload a new video. So as a part of the nephrology lecture series, in this video we'll be talking about membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, which is abbreviated as MPGN. Now let's begin. So this is the microscopic appearance of membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. The stain which is used here is called as silver stain. So at the end of this video, you'll be able to identify the microscopic appearance of membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, and you'll be able to identify the clinical features and much more about the same disease. So keep watching till the end and don't forget to subscribe. So in membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, there is deposits of immune complexes in the glomeruli in the kidney, and I'll tell you exactly where it is in the next couple of slides. Okay, the deposits of the immune complexes will lead to glomerular damage, and this is what's happening in membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. But we'll see everything in detail. I'm just telling a simple overview of the entire thing. So we'll just go through one by one in the upcoming slides. So there are basically two types of membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. The first one is type 1 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, and there is type 2 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, which is also known as dense deposit disease. So now this is an entirely different disease. Now this is separated from type 1 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, and the pathogenesis is somewhat different in both of these, but the microscopic features and clinical features are somewhat similar in both of these. So in this video, we'll be focusing mainly on the type 1 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. I'll be making a separate video on type 2 MPGN very soon. So why is it called so? Why is it membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis? It's because there is a deposition of immune complexes in the glomeruli that will lead to thickening of the glomerular basement membrane that will give the appearance of an enlarged glomerular basement membrane. And apart from that, there is proliferation of mesangial cells, capillary endothelium, and there is infiltration of various leukocytes, and this gives an appearance of which is described as lobular appearance. Okay, so I'll show you the picture in a minute. So what you need to know is that increased proliferation of these cells in the glomeruli, that's why the name has the word proliferative in it. And since the membrane is, the glomerular basement membrane is thickened, and that's why it is called as membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. Okay, so keep watching. So once again, I'm showing you the slide. As you can see here, this is the silver stain of a kidney, which shows in high magnification a glomeruli. As you can see here, there are many black things which you can see here. This is what basically shows the glomerular basement membrane, and you can see here that there are so many things which are apart from the normal glomeruli. Okay, so this is not how a normal glomerular actually looks like. There is actually increased proliferation of the mesangium in the center and everywhere in this slide, and you can see two layers of black circles around the glomerular capillaries, and I'll tell you what it is in a minute. So let's say about the pathogenesis. So based on the pathogenesis, MPGN is classified into primary MPGN, which is idiopathic, and secondary MPGN, which is secondary to some known diseases. So the cause of primary MPGN is not clearly known. That's why it is called as idiopathic. In secondary MPGN, MPGN occurs secondary to some immune disorders, or secondary to some chronic infections such as hepatitis B or hepatitis C, etc. So there is basically immune complex deposition, and as you all know, immune complex is formed between an antigen and an antibody. So in this case, in membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, In most of the cases, the antigens are from infectious agents such as hepatitis B virus, hepatitis C virus, and HIV virus. So in all these cases, when a person is chronically infected by these viruses, what happens is the antigens of these viruses will form immune complexes with antibodies present in the patients, and these may get planted or deposited in the glomeruli. And the most common site is beneath the endothelium, which is known as subendothelial deposits. Okay, so in this picture, you can see right here the thing which is marked over here with the big black arrow. You can see that there are some black deposits which are present just below the capillary endothelium and above the glomerular basement membrane. The pink thing which covers the entire the picture is glomerular basement membrane. Okay, so the intermittent orange things are the capillary endothelium, and these deposits are present just beneath the capillary endothelium, so they are subendothelial deposits. So the glomerular basement membrane is also affected in this disease, and it shows characteristic appearances. So it is thickened, and there is a classical appearance which is described as double contour or tram track appearance. So the same picture, as you can see here, as I told you earlier, you can see that the glomerular capillaries seem to have two walls, right? Kind of two layers of black surroundings over the glomerular capillaries. That's because of two main reasons. As is pointed over this particular point, you can see that there is separation of the glomerular basement membrane. So you can see two separate layers, right? Two separate black layers. That's because of two main reasons. One is there will be new glomerular basement membrane formation over the pre-existing one, and that is induced by the subendothelial deposits. And the second reason for that is deposition of the immune complexes itself will show this kind of appearance. So deposition of the immune complexes sometimes can happen in the glomerular basement membrane itself, and that can give rise to an appearance of two separate glomerular basement membrane. Okay, so remember that this stain is glomerular, this stain is silver stain of a highly magnified glomeruli, and the characteristic appearance in this condition, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, is double contour or tram track appearance. The clinical features of these patients is that they can manifest either as nephrotic syndrome, which is classically a triad of proteinuria, generalized edema, and hyperlipidemia, and they can also present with a combined symptoms of nephritic syndrome, which has various symptoms, but in these patients the most common symptom of nephritic syndrome is hematuria, which is bleeding in urine. Okay, so these are the main clinical features of these patients. So how do you manage these patients? The most commonly tried things are corticosteroids, immunosuppressants, but they are not so satisfactory as with most of the cases of nephrotic syndrome, except for minimal change disease. As you all know that there the response is so drastic, the patient responds very well. But in this case, these drugs do not help very well, but still you have to try. And in severe cases, we can do renal transplantation and the patient may survive with that. But still, even after a renal transplantation, there may be deposits, as you can as you saw in the previous slides, there can be deposits in the transplanted kidney also, but those patients do not develop renal failure and all. It's kind of better to do renal transplantation if the other modalities of management are not possible. So prognosis, how do the treatment help and what will happen? So this condition is slowly progressive, so it keeps on worsening slowly, and about 50% of the patients, even if you treat vigorously, they develop chronic renal failure, and that's kind of worse. So we came to the end of the video. If you like this video, please leave a like, share this video to your friends, and comment below. I need to hear from you. few people are giving valuable suggestions, and I'm so happy about that. So help me reach 200 subscribers, and thank you all for watching. And if you want me to make more videos, please support me on www.patreon.com/medvidsmadesimple. The link is given in the description of this video, so you can donate any amount starting from $1. That will help me a lot. So thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.